you know, they want to attract yield aggregator. That's the best approach to grow up the multi-BTC. So that is why they are launching the three pool for BTC, multi-BTC, WBTC, and SBTC. Then current their TVL is around 5 million. It's good. Hi, hello, I'm mr.masa. So today's the investor review for the Multichain token called Multi. Since I'm going to update the total score of the Multi, let's review it. Okay. And then this is my portfolio strategy. So I only recommend assets that are Bitcoin and all the altcoin which related to these seven categories on the right side. Then if you want a deeper understanding about my portfolio strategy, please check out my video about my portfolio strategy. Then here's my video link. Yep. Then today's matching category for the Multichain is number 4 DEX. Then since they're going to provide cross-chain bridge solutions, that is why number 7 blockchain interoperability is another matching category too. Then as usual, I'm going to apply the 6 Anaka points aside for the pain points, product, team, execution power, token economy, and hype cycle. Then for each, I set the 5.0 point here, so the total score is 30.30. Then if you want a deeper understanding about how I'm going to analyze each point here, please check out my video about my altcoin investment strategy. Then here's my video link. Okay. Then here's total score updates about the Multi. As of now, so last time, May 2022, total score is 27.0 point. This time, January 2023, total score is 27.0 point, same points. Then since my minimum investment criteria is over 25 points, so from this perspective, I'm going to continue to recommend investment in multi-chain token, Multi. Then these remark area here, such as product, there is no score change, but I have a critical updates about this project. Then from here, I'm going to tell you the detail. Okay? Then number 1, pain point analysis. There is no critical change here. So about pain point, higher gas fee on Ethereum accelerates cross-chain transaction demands on yield farming. Then as you can see here, it's pretty crystal clear. Ethereum gas fee, it's the biggest and most expensive one. That's why we need other L1 and also L2. Okay? That is why, you know, lots of dApps, they're going to take the multi-chain approach. CarFine is a good example. Then a lot of yield farmer, yield aggregator, make lots of money through Curve ecosystem. Why? Because they have the biggest stable asset pool. Then, you know, all the time they are thinking about the minimize the gas fee to maximize the return for this. So from this perspective, they're gonna use cross-chain bridge solutions. Then Multichain is the number one player here, okay? Then next one, product analysis. Then I have two critical updates about this project this time, okay? Then before moving to these two major topics, let's overview their product. So simply say their product is cross-chain router protocol. Then they are the fast mover in this area. So look at their number here, total volume, total TVL, token and the chains, literally they are the number one. Okay. Then here is the system overview of the multi-chain. I call it mint and burn model. Then one of the great product advantage, technical advantage of the solution is they can transact two assets, fungible token like Ethereum, also non-fungible token like NFT, both of them. Then additionally, also they can run some kind of a transaction fee revenue share program like Car Finance by using their VE multi-tokenomics. That's why it's also great too for the, you know, multi-stakeup player here. Okay. Then here's two major update topic, multi-BTC and ZK router. Then let's start for multi-BTC. So first of all, why they gonna launch multi-BTC at this moment, right? Because of this, FTX craps and also Celsius bankruptcy. Lots of retail investors lost their trust against CeFi, Central Exchange. But we have to still rely on this. Look at this one. Trading volume comparison between Central Exchange and the DEX. In the beginning of the January, trading volume difference between Central Exchange and DEX was 6 to 1. But last week, January 2017, volume level, volume difference is 12 to 1, widening. Why? Because still the major transactions on Web3 space, largest one led by Bitcoin. Look at their dominance ratio, over 40%. That's why most of the DeFi DEX only support L1 or L2, you know, assets like Ethereum or Solana, those kind of things. Bitcoin is fully isolated chain from this ecosystem here. That is why somebody have to support this one. Especially wrapped Bitcoin is the most ultimate and ideal solution for this topic here. Then I do think WBTC, wrapped Bitcoin, is a sleeping giant. Because look at this one. Only 1% of the total market cap of BTC is covered by WBTC as of now. Even as of now. They're too small, right? Then why this is too small? Because of this. To mint wrapped Bitcoin, we have to still rely on centralized player, like CeFi player, because we need their centralized custodian solutions to mint wrapped Bitcoin. All right? Then actually, here's one topic what I want you to pay attention here. It's about RenBM. You know, last time bull run and the third bull run, RenBM is one of the leading players for the DeFi space because they are the major player, they're going to mint WBTC. We call it RenBTC. They also provide a similar solution to Zcash or Dutchie, but of course, Bitcoin's the largest one. Then in October 2021, the total TVL on the RenBM hit over 1.8 billion. It was a huge success. Now, almost like about 95% is covered by RenBTC. But the look at number here. After the FTX collapse, this number is also, you know, seriously crashed. So 98.5% crash since its all-time high. It's a huge crash. But simply say, now why this gonna happen? Because of the Alameda research. You know, one of the, you know, major FTX group. Alameda Research was a heavy user of RenBTC. Their old money, they're going to use it, it was gone because of its collapse. So RenBTC is collapsing. Multichain, they're going to pay attention to this because they're going to run lots of transactions between RenBTC and other chain transaction stuff. So they want to be a primary successor of RenBTC. That's the primary motivations. They're going to launch Multi-BTC. Then I do think they are the right player to run this project. Why? Because they are the cross-chain router player, largest one. That is why they can connect between Bitcoin chain and Ethereum chain to manage multi-BTC, especially price ratio between 1-to-1 against Bitcoin. Then here's, you know, detailed explanation about the multi-BTC. How does multi-BTC work? So multi-BTC is an ERC-20 token issued by the multi-chain protocol that is pegged to the value of the Bitcoin. This means that one multi-BTC is always equal to one BTC. Multi-BTC allows users to take advantage of the feature and the capability of the Ethereum blockchain, such as smart contract, while still being able to hold and trade a Bitcoin. The peg between multi-BTC and Bitcoin is maintained with the help of smart contract on the Ethereum and HTLC, hash time locked contract on the Bitcoin network. The whole process is completely decentralized and automated. It's beautiful. I love this. Then contract address on Ethereum is this one. The contract address on BTC is this one. Yep. Then note, the 1918 DGSA address on Bitcoin is a corrective address. It's a correction address. The deposit will only be gathered to the correction address when more than a deposit from separate users' BTC deposit address come in. Because BTC database is based on UTXO, that's why. Yep. Then how are they gonna grow this multi-BTC? Use curve finance. It's pretty, you know, normal approach because, you know, they wanna attract yield aggregator. That's the best approach to grow up the multi-BTC. So that is why they are launching the three pool for BTC, multi-BTC, WBTC, and SBTC. Then current their TVL is around 5 million. It's good. Then also they are planning to take the bribe solutions on a convex finance to increase the TVL. That's also good. Then, you know, most importantly, how many DeFi aggregator show their interest? Then At this moment, Constant Letter, powered by R&D DAO, also BP Finance, they're gonna allocate their assets. They're gonna build their boats by using this, you know, WBTC pool. This is great too. I love this. But here are the one things. Why don't you pay attention to here? It's about the WBTC. Why? It's because this. So actually, WBTC is the largest, you know, wrapped BTC solutions in a Web3 space. It's actually based on centralized custodial model. It's powered by BitGo. That's why it's a huge problem or huge potential risk, because BitGo might tend to be just like FTX. We don't know yet, but it might happen. That's why it's a huge potential risk out there, right? Then to solve this problem here, one of my expectations about the entire Web3 ecosystem is this one, Web3 smartphone. Why do I think so? Which is related to this topic here, account abstractions on the wallet dApps. Look at the bottom one, signing schemes, security. The current common signing scheme in Ethereum is a single signing scheme, ECDSA, and one encrypted curve. Quantum computer can break ECDSA. Thus, we need post-quantum safe signature algorithm, Ramport or Winternet, for example. Also, a different signature scheme could let you use the secure enclave of iOS and Android devices to turn smartphone into your hardware wallets with over 6 billion smartphone users globally. But we cannot control Apple and Google, right? That is why building blockchain OS is a shortcut or most ideal model to realize this goal here. Then once blockchain OS, like Solana Mobile, can realize, you know, self-custodian wrapped BTC model, you don't have to rely on Bitcoin anymore or any kind of centralized exchange to mint your wrapped Bitcoin solutions to allocate assets in the DeFi space. Right? Then with these innovations, I do think that DeFi product movements related to BTC or the wrapped Bitcoin solutions will be accelerated. Not only about the liquidity mining, also we're gonna see another innovations, right? That is why that will be pretty important for us to think about, you know, this topic at this moment, okay? Then from this perspective, also I do think multi-chain is the right player because they are also, they're connecting their router solution to Solana chain. It's a great execution. I love it, okay? Then next one, ZK Router. Then as we know, these days, zero knowledge proof is one of the biggest topic on a, you know, BaaS or L1 and L2 player layer here. Why? Because look at this number here. You know, a lot of players start to use, you know, L1, alternative L1, cross-chain bridge or like L2. Then because of this, we're gonna see huge hacking trouble happen here between L1 and L2. For example, like Ronin Network, 600 million hack. The other one, 1.4, like when one of the major competitors for the multi, they're gonna hit 320 million hacking. It's pretty big, right? We have to solve this problem as soon as possible. So that is why ZK technology for multi-chain is also pretty important too. Now here's one key thing. We have to understand here why we have to pay attention to ZK. It's because compared with Optimistic Rollup, one of the major rivals for ZK technology, ZK Rollup technology has much more advanced about their security level here, remarkable here. Think about those pretty big hacking trouble. We have to pay attention to ZK Rollup technology here. Then, of course, about a multi-chain, I think they have a certain level of potential to realize such great technology too, which they call ZK Router. Because they are the fast mover in a cross-chain bridge area. They still, they're gonna maintain their edge here. Then also, these days, they're gonna hiring a lot of smart folks to develop their ZK Router. About that point, I'm gonna tell you on the next topic, team analysis here, okay? Then about the key member, you know, all the, you know, co-founding member is pretty active. This is good. Then you know, these days, they're going to aggressively hiring very smart player for their ZK root development. Like Xin Chang is a good example. He's a, you know, chief algorithm security officer at the Multichain. So, you know, they need those smart folks to develop like ZK root technology on their own. Yeah, I think, you know, that is why, you know, we have to pay attention to their product progress. Okay. Then next one, number four, exception power analysis. So there is no big update here. The first of all was we're going to pay attention to breach volume level. Multichain all the time number one as a cross-chain breach. Then their major rival is number four, Stellar Sea breach, and also number seven, Stargate. Okay. Then about community stats, Multichain also hold the largest Twitter number here. Then about the Discord, you know, I'm going to pay attention to Stargate. I think around 50K here, it's pretty amazing number here. Yeah. So I think it probably Stargate will be the major rival for Multichain. That's what I'm thinking about. Okay. Then next one, token economy analysis. Then token economy design metrics which are made, then the major matching category for them is DEX and blockchain interoperability. Okay. Then about their token economics, of course, VMulti is a major one. And then, you know, there is no big change here. Then compares curve, you know, CRV token economies, one of the critical differences is transaction fee pool. They're going to pay by USD. You know, curve finance case, they're going to pay by CRV tokens. It's a broader asset. So multi-V case is actually a much more stable one. It's a great advantage for them too, right? Okay. Now, of course, you know, like VCRV, they're going to require longer staking, larger staking. Those players can maximize their revenue share from multi-ecosystem on their staking solution here. Then these days, a lot of players copy the VMulti too. A good example is Stargate, VESTZ. Then all the time, I'm going to pay attention to two KPI to compare these key stats here. Percentage of rocked in circulations and average rock time. Multichain, VMulti hit 21.32. Then average rock time is 3.5 years. Completely overwhelmed VSTG. This is great. Then this one, network effect on multi. There is no big change. But I think once they're gonna successfully, you know, ZK looter, also like especially multi BTC, these, you know, proof stuff, I think, you know, their network effect model, it much gets stronger. This is great for them. Okay. Then about the benchmark analysis, January 2023. Market cap of the multi is 153 million. The Stargate, 63 million. The interesting point is, you know, once we're going to look at the last time when I analyzed Stargate, December 2022, their market cap is 55 million. The multi chain is 70 million. Look at this difference here. How the multi chain, they're going to maintain fast mover all the time, can maintain strongest market momentum compared with other competitors here. As far as they have a most advanced execution power, also technical edge of their product. That's a critical requirement to maintain the positioning as fast mover. Just like Ethereum, same things, okay? Then about governance DAO, it's getting active. That's good for them too. We have to scaling up their DAO, much more proactive way to compete with other tech giant Web2, okay? Then number six, life cycle analysis. So here is a Gartner App Cycle Analysis, Blockchain Web3, 2022. Then their major matching category is actually a lot. DApps, Blockchain Wallets, Blockchain Platform, DeFi, Interoperability, NFT, DEX, Layer 2, Web3, Oracle, Zero Knowledge Proof, and DAO, a lot. But since, you know, they are kind of back-end player for their entire, like Web3, you know, those kind of chain management ecosystem here, that is why it's kind of a little bit niche. But, you know, I think gradually DT investor recognize that, you know, how the cross-chain bridge solution is pretty important for them. Like a primary, like in a function for, you know, entire Web3 platform here. Okay. Then final item, total score updates. About pain point without any change, 5.0. We need cross-chain bridge platform. Okay. Product, 4.5. So it's a great key updates about the ZK router and multi-BTC, right? But still no squad change, okay? Team level 4.5, all the time they are pretty capable team. And then also they are hiring a lot of smart folks on a security area here for their ZK router developments. That's also great too, okay? Execution power 4.5, always, you know, number one execution capability compared with other competitor here. So that's why 45. So that is why 4.5. Token economy 4.0. Still, compared with VCRV, I think their two major KPI is a little bit behind. So that is why, you know, they have to achieve sustainable improvement here. That's why I set the 4.5 here. Hype cycle 4.5, but simply because lots of great hot topic matching category here for them. So 4.5. So total score is 27.0 point. Then my minimum investment criteria is over 25 points. So from this perspective, I'm gonna continue to recommend investment in multi-chain token, multi. Then if you're interested, much more detailed information about my portfolio allocations and also my real time, but I didn't set a signal for every single crypto assets, including ICO, ID on DeFi, please think about to join my premium membership program real time, but I didn't set a signal. The major purpose of this membership program to help to reach your crypto asset performance to my level here. The for more detail, please check out my video. Then here's my video link. Yep. That is all this time, so I'm gonna make this video for educational purpose. So I'm not gonna guarantee you any kind of certain level investment outcome with this video, in this video that I make. But I truly hope that my video will practically help you guys understand about high potential about crypto and multi space. So I'm gonna make a lot of this video crypto and multi space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.